Welcome to another legacy video here on channelfireball.com. I've got a kind of unique deck today. Zero lands. In fact, this is, well, this is the enemy. I've joined the dark side. This is Manaless Dredge. So this deck's very bizarre. In fact, one of my complaints with this deck is that it doesn't really feel like playing Magic, whether you play with or against it. And, well, it doesn't have any lands in it, so even one land Belcher taps mana and plays spells. This deck just can't generate mana. So what does this deck do? First of all, it's on the draw. You always want to start going second, so you can discard on turn one. You can never mulligan. I mean, there are theoretical hands that could cause you to mulligan, but every opening hand, you either want a Dredge card, Golgari Grave Troll being the best one, along with a Stinkweed Imp, Golgari Thug, and even the lowly Shambling Shell, or a Phantasmagorian plus a Dredge card, where you can discard this, then you just get to discard three cards. You can even stack it and discard multiple times in case you want to get your whole hand into your graveyard. Then you have cards like Gitaxian Probe and Street Wraith, which give you extra draws, more dredges. You flip Nether Shadow, Narcomoeba, or Ikrid into your graveyard. Those all come back by themselves without any mana. That brings back Prized Amalgam along with them. And then you have Brig from Below. So you have a bunch of tokens in play, or you have a bunch of creatures in play. You sack them to Cabal Therapy, and you get a bunch of Bridge tokens. Then you Dread Return, Balustrade Spy, or Whirlpool Drake. And you end up milling your whole deck. And then you get to Dread Return, Flayer of the Hatebound, and something else, and just kill them. It's also got some Chancellors of the Annex, because they start in your opening hand and disrupt your opponent a little bit. All the sideboard cards don't cost mana, because that's how this deck has to work. Contagion against creature decks, Fairy Macabre against graveyard decks, Leyline against, well, decks that target you, and Force of Will against combo decks. Your game one is pretty good against decks that aren't fast combo. Postboard games, of course, get harder. And, well, the deck's really, really weird, so let's see how this goes. Alrighty, would I like to play first? No. Wow, this is kind of the nut draw. The only bad thing is you have Narcomoeba in your opening hand, so you kind of want that one just to be in your deck to mill later. But other than that, this deck is, or this draw is pretty fantastic. I start with double Chancellor of the Annex, so my opponent basically has to just run a spell into the Chancellors, because they'll both trigger on the first spell, so you're not getting a whole lot of value here. And well, if you're new to Legacy, this is going to be quite the trip. And then I get to discard Phantasmagorian and then discard these three dredgers and basically get to dredge every turn. My best draw would be a Gitaxian Probe, I believe, or Street Wraith, actually. Probe lets me see their hand for Cabal Therapy, but Street Wraith offers a creature for Ikrid, so it's probably still Probe, since I'll have Phantasmagorian to get eaten by Ikrid. Well, let's see what my opponent leads with. Something that gets countered by Chancellor of the Annex, most likely. And here we go. Ponder. Taste it, Ponder. Alright. Well, Bridge from Below is not really what I wanted. But now I get to at least discard multiple cards to Phantasmagorian. Discard Phantasmagorian. End of my opponent's turn. I'm gonna remember to hold down Control on Magic Online. Discard basically my whole hand except for Narcomoeba to get back Phantasmagorian. And well, go from there. Well, Deathrite Shaman's not bad, but it's not, I think it will be too slow here. We'll find out. So let's discard these three and discard these three. Alright. Untap, Dredge, Golgari Grave Troll. And you can't put them back in any just any order because you have Nether Shadow. But since I didn't hit a Nether Shadow, I'm actually fine here. All right, pass my opponent. If they don't, especially if they don't have green mana, then Deathrite Shaman is just not going to be that relevant. Yes, they can eat like a, not even a Bridge from Blue. They could eat like a Dread Return, but that is fine. Not the best dredge. Didn't hit any Ikarids or Narcomoebas or Nether Shadows. Not even a Prized Amalgam. But it's still, well, I've got plenty of gas left to go. You are limited to one dredge per turn once you have exhausted any opportunity to have Gitaxian Probe or Street Wraith, but which I have, because I'm not actually going to draw. Well, if all goes according to plan, I'm not going to have another natural draw step. But that's okay. I guess Whirlpool Drake is a reason to have cards in hand, but at some point I still will potentially discard my hand here. I'm just going to dredge a Golgari Grave Troll without discarding my hand at the moment, but that could certainly change depending on what my opponent does or more what I dredge into my own graveyard here. Well, see what my opponent does now. Saxy Flooded Strand is, I guess, the start. They have Tropical Island to go get, most likely. And when they do, they can pay a green and tap Deathrite Shaman, yep, to exile Golgari Grave Troll. And maybe that'll be fast enough because I didn't hit anything on the first go-round. But I think I'll still got a shot here. Plus, well, if Manaless Dredge can't beat a Deathrite Shaman on turn two, then, well, I'm not saying it can't beat it, but we'll see how that goes. I've got Double Bridge from Below. I already have a Dread Return, so if I hit Narcomoeba and Cabal Therapy and another Bridge or two Narcomoebas, I've got an option. All right. The Exiled Whirlpool Drake, that is not the card I would exile at this point in time. They're going to Cabal Therapy me. I think I'm just going to discard my hand to Phantasmagorian. Because I don't want to end up with two cards in hand and not be able to bring back Phantasmagorian. I'd rather just have all the Grave Trolls in the graveyard. My opponent wants to make me discard Phantasmagorian. I guess they can. And sure. Phantasmagorian down. It's probably better for it to be in my graveyard since I can exile it to Ikarid. And they're going to flash it back, removing my two bridges. Okay, I actually think that's fine. I'd rather have no Deathrite in play than the two bridges in my graveyard. Okay. Alright, well, I'll Dredge Golgari Grave Troll. And, well, no, nothing good. Alright. I hit a bunch of Dread Returns and a Balustrade Spy. More Dredgers, but still I've bricked completely on Ikarids, Nether Shadows, Narcomoebas. I mean, I know I drew the one Narcomoeba already. Unearth! Oh no, the Deathrite's back. Okay, let's get another Grave Troll in. Ooh, I hit an Narcomoeba and a Nether Shadow, so let's put... And... Alright, because this is... Oh, creature cards above it. Shoot, I did it the wrong way. Let's see, so... Prized Amalgam's going to come back. I guess it actually wouldn't have come back this turn because Prized Amalgam is also jumping. The question is, do I want a Cabal Therapy? And given I have zero Bridge from Belows, I don't think I want a Cabal Therapy right now. Though I do want Prized Amalgam to come back, which it will. Hooray. All right. Prized Amalgam gets in there. And now my opponent can exile one card. I still have multiple Dredgers in here. Yes, I have Stinkweed Imp and Golgari Thug. And Shambling Shell, and Golgari Thug, and Stinkweed Imp. So, not doing too badly here. So my opponent's just going to pass. So yeah, Nether Shadow should have a Street Wraith above it. Let's hope that doesn't come back to bite me here. Looks like it will not. Alright, boom. Narcomoeba comes back. Unless my opponent Deathrite Shamans it, which they might. Alright, Narcomoeba's gone. Let's take yes anyway, even though it doesn't do anything. And I'm going to attack for 4. I don't think... I could Cabal Therapy because I have Bridge from Below, but I would rather hit another Bridge before doing that. So I think I'm just going to pass. I have Phantasmagorian too, so Nether Shadow is definitely coming back next turn. I have one bridge left in my deck, and I'm going to get to dredge 6 on my turn. Also, I'm getting some beats in. Not too bad. Brainstorm, sure. Alright, my opponent found a fetch land, which... That makes that Brainstorm a little better, but... Besides Deathrite Shaman, there aren't tons of cards my opponent could have that are super relevant here. I suppose if they find another Cabal Therapy, they can trim down on the number of bridges I have down to just one. But honestly, this deck doesn't need all the bridges. Like, I'm playing against a fair, intrinsically fair deck. If I just get all my Prized Amalgams into play, then that could work. Second death rite could be annoying. Third death rite, I guess, could also be annoying. Alright, this next dredge, I think, is going to need to be decent here. Acreage down, sure. So, let's discard these three. Another shadow comes back. Alright, dredge, Golgari, Grave Troll. Ooh, I hit another bridge, okay. So now, let's go Cabal Therapy, my opponent, sacking Narcomoeba, triggering two bridges. And I'm gonna name Force of Will. Their hand is two Force of Wills. I'm a genius. Also, that's just the card you name against a tapped out opponent. So I do have a Balustrade Spy, and I have one Narcomoeba left. Yeah, that should be fine still. Let's see. Let me do this before I screw myself up completely. If I Dread Return Balustrade Spy, I sack these two and a zombie, and I end up with 2, 4, 5 tokens. Mill my whole deck. And then I sack Balustrade Spy and 2 tokens. So I end up with still 5 tokens and get Flare of the Hatebound back. And then I... So that's 2-1, so I have 4 Dread Returns. And then I can sack Flare and a token. So I think that's enough. So Flare comes in, deals 4, puts my opponent to 14. I sack Flare, get back Chancellor of the Annex. And that deals my opponent, because it comes back with Undying, another, or get Phantasmagorian. Yeah, I think that's enough. All right. Dread Return, targeting. Balustrade Spy, sack, sack, sack. All right. All right, and so, and I get another Narcomoeba. Yeah. So that's Dread Return again. Dread Return targeting Flare of the Hatebound. Yeah, this should be more than good. Alright. Boom, hit my opponent for 4. Then Dread Return targeting Phantasmagorian, sacking Flare and 2 zombies. Flare comes back. Deals 5. Prize Amalgams trigger a million times. Phantasmagorian comes back. Deals 6. And then Dread Return one more time on, say, Phantasmagorian. But this time I have to remember to sack the tokens. And bam. Alright. We muddled our way through it. And sideboard against this deck, I don't think I really sideboard anything. I guess Contagion kills Deathrite Shaman, and that's like maybe slightly better than, like, I honestly don't even know what you can trim all that much. But I'll take out a Whirlpool Drake and maybe a Chancellor of the Annex. Wow, I probably sideboarded great here. Alrighty, my opponent chose to play. Awesome. I'm gonna keep this hand. It has a Dredger and a Phantasmagorian. You should not choose to play against this deck, because I just have to say go. You get to be on the play and the draw if you choose to go second, because on turn one, I'm just going to say go. So, that is an introduction to Legacy. It's not intuitive. I can't blame my opponent for not knowing, but it is kind of funny. Opponent mulliganing. Likely to look for some hatred. A little bit of a anti-graveyard card, whatever it is those might be. So my turn one is hopefully... Well, my turn one is discard Phantasmagorian. The question is, hopefully my opponent's turn one is not Deathrite Shaman. Uh-oh, I can feel it. Yeah. Oh, Ponder. Well, in that case, wise. Chancellor of the Annex, kind of the unsung hero last game. Opponent would have likely played a turn one Deathrite Shaman if not for a Chancellor. And let us discard him up. So I'm going to discard... See, this is great. I'm going to discard everything but the Balustrade Spy. And I'm going to end up with two Prized Amalgams, two Bridge from Blows. Ikarid... Well, it's actually awkward, isn't it? I want to bring back Ikarid, but I can't really bring back Ikarid by eating Golgari Thug. I wonder what that means. Well, I've got a couple options. One is I can discard Balustrade Spy and have Ikarid eat that instead. The other is... Well, I can't really discard Golgari Thug. The other is I could have it eat a Prized Amalgam, but that seems worse. And then I have to leave... That also means I have to leave one of these cards from my hand in play. Or in my hand still. Alright, my opponent looking for potentially Deathrite Shaman or maybe a more harsh hate card like a, I don't know, Grafdigger's Cage or Tormod's Crypt. Those are a little specific, and I would say the four color, like, good stuff decks don't always play them. Alright, there goes Deathrite. So, end of my opponent's turn, I'm going to discard Ikarid, Golgari Thug, certainly, and at least one Amalgam. So I think I want to just maximize for getting some Amalgams into play. And I think that it means I end up leaving a Bridge from Below in my hand. I guess I could just not... No, I have to Dredge. So I'm going to discard Amalgam, Bridge, Balustrade Spy. And I think that there's some debate there. I'll get this thing in next turn. So Ikarid, eat Balustrade Spy. Amalgams trigger. Dredge Golgari Thug. Ooh, I hit a Cabal Therapy. That's interesting. Alright, so let's just attack. If my opponent wants to block and trade, they can. Alright. And now I have one Bridge. So the question is... Oh man, I hit another Amalgam too. Very nice. Do I want to blow a Cabal Therapy here? That doesn't give me any additional zombies. I can Cabal Therapy myself and put a Bridge in the graveyard. I already have a Thug and a Shambling Shell, so I have some outlets. I kind of don't think... So what is my opponent going to Deathrite next turn? They're going to Deathrite probably the Ikarid. I'm going to have two Amalgams in play, plus a token no matter what. I don't care about Force of Will. Basically, I don't care about anything to get to Cabal Therapy. So the question is, do I want a Cabal Therapy? Like, I already have two Dredgers, so they can't eat a Dredger. Could Cabal Therapy a Bridge? But I think the Ikarid's going to get eaten next turn anyway. And if I wait a turn, I can discard it all to Phantasmagorian. So I think I just wait. I would be open to the idea that I'm wrong. This deck is, I think, much harder to play than I initially gave it credit for. So I don't know enough about what my opponent's got in hand to know whether I should have Cabal Therapied them. So they're going to kill my Bridge, so I guess I'm glad I didn't have another Bridge. Oh, they're naming Bridge. Oh, yeah, they probed. Okay. Well, that's fair. So now they get to Deathrite away my Ikarid, and then sack Deathrite to Cabal Therapy to get rid of my two Bridges. Well, I'm just going to kill them with two Prized Amalgams and a Zombie Token, and that'll be just fine. It's a two-turn clock, conveniently. And if I hit a Narcomoeba on this Golgari Thug, game. Oh, they killed my Prized Amalgam. Well, I guess without the Bridges, the Ikarid's less good, but I assume they're going to Cabal Therapy here. Well, Ikarid's still going to come out to play, I think. And are they going to make me discard? That's... No, they're not. Goat Napper. Okay, that's smart. They should not make me discard here. Could have a Swords to Plowshares. Alright, Yeah, I'm gonna Icarid off of Shambling Shell and then Dredge off Golgari Thug. Ooh, that was a good dredge because I hit a Phantasmagorian and I hit an Archamoeba. So the question now is, does my opponent's deck play something like Supreme Verdict? There's just not much else they can do. I don't think they have Toxic Deluge. Okay, they have Swords to Plowshares. That doesn't surprise me. So I'm going to, I think I Cabal Therapy them now, just sacking the Icarid because it's going away anyway. Two cards in hand. What can they even have that I really, really care about? The answer is just like so little. I guess a second Swords to Plowshares. It's like a bit weak, but all right. Cabal Therapy and Death Rite Shaman. Yeah, see, I don't even care about those. Like Death Rite is not fast enough in some cases. I think turn one Death Rite often will be because you can just eat right away and get ahead of things, but this is just not working out for my opponent, I don't think. Like Cabal Therapy just does stone nothing here, so end of my opponent's turn, Phantasmagorian discarding these three. So then I get to untap, Icarid off of Phantasmagorian, and then Dredge Golgari Thug. And now I did it correctly. I put the Nether Shadow under the creatures. Wow, I'm great. And then let's go ahead and slam with everything. Yeah. And well, I was learning the ropes too, but good match, and the evil dredgers win.